Enable the Extra Objects add-on that comes with Blender. Press Shift-A and go to Mesh Extras Wall Factory. Increase the end value to 30 or more. Select all in Edit mode and scale the stones with Alt-S until they almost overlap. Add a bevel modifier. Add a simple deform modifier and set it to bend 360 degrees along the Z-axis. You can type higher values in this field if you need to close the loop. To increase the height of the tower, add an array modifier with the relative offset in the Z-axis. To add some variation on the top, hide the current object and add another wall. Add some crenels. Repeat the previous steps to make this part circular and place it at the top of the tower. Then unhide the previous wall. Apply these modifiers with Ctrl-A, Visual Geometry to Mesh. You can use a Remesh modifier set to Voxel to make the wall look a bit more organic and realistic. Now let's add some ivy to this. In Preferences, enable the Add Curve Ivy Gen add-on that comes with Blender by default. Hold Shift and right-click to place the 3D cursor where you want the ivy to start. Make sure the wall is selected and click on Add New Ivy. You can experiment with the settings and then click on Update Ivy to see the changes. Max Ivy Length controls how far the ivy grows. Gravity makes it look like it's being pulled down by its own weight. Randomness makes it more random. Wherever you place the 3D cursor is where the new ivy will grow. Once you click somewhere else, you can no longer change the settings. Then you can add the materials to the leaves and to the stem curves. Keep in mind that the more ivy you have, the heavier the scene will be. Click on the square field on the right to get my free ebook sample PDF.